So Jalen Withers ready to tip it off against Charles Bassey. The Hilltoppers on the road in the red, and Louisville here at home in the white. So Johnson, as usual, starts in the backcourt for Louisville. They're looking for a step up from him this year. First bucket of the day belongs to Jalen Withers, the redshirt freshman out of Charlotte, North Carolina.
Time Johnson works off of a UCLA cut. It's going to be a post-up opportunity. Western Kentucky smells it out quickly.
And Carlake Jones, when he gets the open opportunity from three, wilts is Carson Williams. He's not the tallest player on the floor, but he might be one of the strongest. And Bassey shows off his ability to get the Hilltoppers on the board.
Well, he's a special athlete for that size, and so impressed with where he is with his conditioning and his body coming back from a broken leg for a big guy. And that's the best athlete on the floor right there.
Jimmy.
Yeah, the athleticism of four in red just jumps off. And
they go for the one-handed rebound. It bounces away but stays with Hollingsworth. He squirms into the lane. Three straight buckets. Johnson was looking for the post up. Had his pocket picked by Hollingsworth. Off balance. All the scoring for Western Kentucky in about the last 90 seconds as the offense has gotten going in a flurry, and David Johnson snuffs it out. Hollingsworth down the lane. And what a start for Western Kentucky as he gets the bucket. But Western Kentucky has shown quite an ability to do that so far. Louisville has it taken away, nice. Quickly earns it back. A spin move to the bucket for Dre David. Tavion Hollingsworth, the last 6 points for Western Kentucky. These drop for Carson Williams. They've got Bassey inside. Don't even have to feed it to him every time. Sometimes the ball finds him. He scores and one.
Yeah, the ball finds him because he is so active and so quick. And that's a play or two or a pass or two ahead. And that's a rare combination with that type of a big body.
How does that separate him from, let's say, the average post player in college basketball? So Johnson to the corner finds Davis. He launches and he's got it. On the drive, an uncontested half to the hoop for Jordan Rawls.
Got to guard the ball. No shot to beat a good team.
Bassey wipes that away. And up and in for Aiden Igiehan. Was waiting on the opposite side.
Still in rebounding. He misses the first one. Bam, goes and gets it. Watch. That is a slick move and great vision. Really, he felt where Igiehan was.
This is Rawls. Three is good.
And Rawls can shoot the ball.
And a shot clock violation for Louisville. Their spacing was discombobulated. No flow on that possession.
Rick Stansberry went from man-to-man to 2-3 zone when the shot clock got under 10.
Bucket is good. It stops almost a three-minute drought.
And Cooper's fired up a couple of perimeter shots that he doesn't need to take. I mean, 21 in red is not a shooter at all. Not only of Bassey, but Josh Anderson can just eat you up, man.
On the inbounds, perfect underneath for Jalen Withers. He did a good job catching passes in traffic, finishing, and being much more engaged and ready on offense. Down the floor, Davis gets the lay-in.
Well, Louisville's guarding the ball now. It's been a while since Western has had a straight line drive, and that pack defense is working in a really nice rise-up shot. Going straight fastballs at Louisville's defense, as good as Bassey is, it's not going to work.
Wide open look for Igiehan.
Impossible to make a wing entry because that help side defense is on the backside just sitting there waiting on it. That's over.
And Bassey with a drop step and the easiest finish of the day. Josh Nickelberry as well, but Chris Mack said we don't feel like Nickelberry will be able to play during this event here, this multi-team event, in Friday's win over Seton Hall.
And that's a big loss. I think he's a double-figure scorer. That last basket by Western, Bassey should get a screen assist. They've only taken two free throws in this game because of their lack of offense. Louisville's defense has been good, but Western has got to get back to being who they are.
Carlake Jones steps to the basket and scores.
He guarded Bassey on all three of those possessions. He only took 5 2-point attempts.
That's back-to-back buckets for Jones to start the half. In college basketball, Carleek Jones just a few spots ahead of him on that list for Louisville. On the drive, Bassey with the emphatic rejection. Just get the ball with their fingertips. He gets it with the whole palm.
or his elbow.
Hollingsworth helps turn the tide. Gets Western Kentucky within seven.
It could be, because it's really heavily bandaged. And the elbow as well has bothered him. And now this is where he needs to live, talking about Bassey. I think he's growing into his new role. If he has a future in the NBA, it's as a big physical guard that takes care of the ball, not always a high scorer, but just does a lot of things that win you ball games.
Yeah, Bassey, the big physical forward, up to 11 points, 14 rebounds. You said it as we were in our last timeout. He could very easily finish this game with 20 boards.
Yeah, he could.
Very different teams in their first four games.
Yeah, it's a variety of styles. Watch out. Yeah, he's wired to score.
The shot clock. Nearly stripped by McKnight.
Rick Stansberry goes with a 2-3 zone.
An awkward angle. Trey Davis hits the short corner jet. Corner look. Drops for Kevin Osawe.
That was almost an impossibly hard shot.
Western Kentucky, a 2-1 mark through their first three games. The freshman McKnight from the top of the key scoops with a left hand and will go to the free throw line to try for three.
Good player. 1-3-1 out of Western Kentucky. They 1-3-1, 2-3. They go zone to man, man to zone, and it doesn't matter when Dre Davis just rises up and fires. Didn't take the cheap way out and have switches that weren't necessary.
Davis started on the perimeter, spins, and shows deft touch getting to the rim. Can they pull themselves back into this?
Not if they keep throwing it to the wrong team. Western Kentucky now has 16 turnovers in this game. And defensively, they're not putting any pressure on Louisville.
I'm going to need 8 sources before I can verify
that. That doesn't sound like something that you would make up. You know, I'm going to say that that's true. That is true.
For U of L. A near bombastic finish from Igiehan. Goes flailing to the opposite end. It turns into a finger roll deuce for Hollingsworth.
Louisville, it's not going to break now. It ain't going away. It is tight and clean tonight.
Jimmy, how does a coach decide that based on time, score, when you bring the pressure?
Look at that Cardinal right there with Adidas sneakers on and dunking the basketball like that. That's as good as we have in college basketball. Name one better on the floor. Each other to get to the charge spot. That ain't good.
Getting right into the lane, Tavion Hollingsworth takes the bucket. Classic in South Dakota, and then from there came straight down here where they've been waiting to take on Louisville. Reverse lay-in, Hollingsworth.
That was a foul.
Season all second-team pick in the ACC and coming off a really solid performance last time out where he had 19.6 assists. They get it underneath for Jalen Withers. For schools, you look up and down the Division I schedule on a given night so far this year. There are schools playing institutions I never heard of before.
Just to get a game in. Really good win for Louisville tonight. And Louisville did not come in too cool, thinking we're in the ACC and this is a team out of our own state that's out of a lesser league.
You're still able to put together a double-digit victory tonight like this. That's really promising.
Well, and this Louisville team's going to continue to grow and change. We're seeing right now won't be the same team that we'll see in mid-February. The Midland kid from San Francisco can really score. I had him last year at Gonzaga. But this is a terrific answer by a ball club. 1 point, only missed 2 shots. Was 7 out of 9. Made defensive plays, got hard-nosed rebounds.
Inside the Yum Center awaits on Friday, Western Kentucky, after its 2-1 start in South Dakota, falls to 2-2. 75-54, the final score.